Welcome to PC Mac. In today's video, I'm going to show you how you can go ahead and install Sync Thing on your Open Media Vault. For this practical, I'm going to use Raspberry Pi 4 2GB version. For those who don't know what is Sync Thing is a software that will help you to sync between two or more devices in any of the direction, like one-way, two-way, or vice versa. So in this video, we are going to set up Sync Thing and try to sync our Windows drive with our Open Media Vault to sync the data from the Windows computer to our Open Media Vault. So let's do it. First of all, we need to find out the IP address of our Open Media Vault. For those who don't know how to set up the static IP address on Open Media Vault, I will leave the link in the description. They can go ahead and watch the video from there. And if you're using a dynamic IP address, you need to use a tool that is Network Wireless Watcher or Angry IP Scanner to scan your network for Open Media Vault. So let's open the software, try to scan the Open Media Vault IP address. So right now you can see the IP address is 49. So before opening the Open Media Vault, let's go ahead and check out the shared drive on our system. So I'm using the IP address, that is 192.168.1.49. So hit enter and you can see we have containers and media. So under containers, we only have one folder, that is Plex. And under media, we have movies and TV shows. So we will sync these two folders and try to get some data from the Windows computer. Now let's just go ahead and open Open Media Vault, and then I'll take you to Portainer. And we are using the command line as we did in the last video for Plex. We are also doing the same thing with Sync Thing. So let's just go ahead and open the Open Media Vault. Now let's open Portainer. So I have already downloaded the Sync Thing image. You can see it right here, and under containers, it's not running. So what I'm going to do here, I'm going to use the command line to install Sync Thing on our machine. So I have made a tutorial about this software. You can just go ahead and check out my web article from my website. So it's right here. You can just go ahead and open it, and I have also put the Portainer link here as well. You can use this link to create your container under Portainer as well. So we are going to use the command line from here. Let's just go ahead and copy this and paste it under Notepad. Now we'll move from the bottom. This is the Linux server Sync Thing path. And above that, the restart policy is unless stopped. And now we need our path of the folder. So here are data 1 and data 2. So we will use movies and TV shows under these paths. So how we can go ahead and access the path? Under Open Media Vault, we move to shared folders and then look for absolute path. And as you can see, the path is quite long. So what we need to do is right click and inspect. Once you click on inspect, you will see this window right here. Click on this arrow. Once you do that, you can select anything from here. So just click on it like this, and you can see it will take you to the path just like that. So the path is right here. You can just double click and to select the path. So copy it. Now move here, and then we'll go ahead and put the path in this location. So we have two folders. One is media and other one is our containers. So first of all, let's use the media folder and change the path here. to movies, and the second one is TV series. Now on the top we will move back and go to containers from here, and under containers we will create a config folder for sync thing. So instead of media, we'll put containers /sync thing and /config. Now this command will automatically create containers, a sync thing folder under containers, and under sync thing it will create a config folder. Now we'll leave the ports as it is, and for the location it's Europe, London, so I'm going to change it to my location. So the location is changed now. Now we require the PU ID and the PG ID. For that we need to run a command. Either you can use PuTTY if you want, or you can use the command line, the PowerShell for Windows. So let's just make it big, and we can SSH to our Open Media Vault from here. My username is PC Mac, so I'm going to use the root here. So I'm logged in. Now we require the PU ID and PG ID for the user PC Mac. Let me just show you my users. You can close the inspect item from here. Then go to users. The user that I'm using is PC Mac. So let's just go back here, and the command is ID and the username. So by typing this command, you can see UID is right here and the GID is here. So UID is 1001 and GID is 100. So let's just go ahead and put it here. Now everything is done. What we need to do is just copy this whole command and paste it here. So the command is paste successfully and hit enter. Once we do that, we'll move here first of all to check whether the folder is created or not. So you can see the folder is created with all the configuration. So let's just go back here. After that, what we need to do is we need to access our sync thing, and the port number that we are going to use is 8384, that is right here. Now let me just take you to the portainer and refresh the screen to check. As you can see, it's working and it's screen running fine here. So let's just try to access sync thing now. 192.168.1.49:8384. Now you can see it will ask the encrypted usage report is sent daily. If you want to check this out, you can click on yes, otherwise just click on no. Now the second thing is the sync thing admin interface is configured to allow remote access without a password. This can easily give hackers access to read or change any file on your computer. Please set a GUI authentication user and password in the setting dialogs. So we can just go ahead and do it from here. You can see the device name is sync thing. We can change it to anything. So let's just name it as PC Mac, and you can see the reporting is disabled, so save it from here. Again move to settings, and you can see GUI user and the password. So let's name it as and use HTTPS for GUI for more security. And here are the themes option, so I love the dark one. Now let's just go ahead and save it. Save the information, advance, continue. Now it will ask for the password, so let's just go ahead and put the username and password again. So we have the sync thing installed on our Raspberry Pi, and as you can see the name is right here, PC Mac. So we consider it as a server because we are trying to move all the data from other devices to our Raspberry Pi. Now what we need a client. So I'm going to make my desktop machine as a client so I can move the data from my desktop machine to my SyncThing server on Raspberry Pi. For that, I have already installed SyncThing on my desktop machine, and you can see the icon on the bottom of the screen. Once you click on it, it will open a window. It will ask you to run the SyncThing. Once you do it, it will run this window and an automatic window will appear on your screen. And the name you can see right here, desktop. So what we are going to do, we are going to just move this window to the side of the screen and make both the windows side by side. Now, what we need to do, we need to add the device, like add this device, this desktop device to the Raspberry Pi so they can communicate with each other. How we can go ahead and do that? We need to click on add remote device and it will automatically detect a device that is nearby it, or you can say in the same network. So how we can check it's the correct device? We can just go ahead and click on action and click on show ID. Once we do that, you can see the same number reflect here. So we just need to click here and give it a name. So let's name it as desktop and save it. Once we save it, let's click on close. It says disconnected, unused. So it's trying to make a connection with this device. Now, once we click on add remote device here, we again need a device ID. So how we can get the device ID? And once it's establish a connection, it will automatically give an option that device PC Mac and the ID want to connect. So once we click on add device and the name is right here already, save. So it's save here. If you want to make any changes, you can go ahead and click on this name, click add it, go to advance, and here is the options and the sharing options. Everything is available here. So this is done. The connection is established between both the devices. Now what we need to do, we need to create folders here that will move the data from computer to our Raspberry Pi. How we can go ahead and do that? First of all, let's create a folder here, add a folder. So it gives us a folder path right here, but we want to use another folder. So the folder is right here, movies. So let's just select this path and do it like this. Let's name it as movies and save it. So this one is saved. We can also go ahead and change the settings, so we'll do it later on. So add another folder, and this time the folder name is, let me just copy it from here. So I have created two folders, one is for TV series. So let's just click here, copy the path and paste it here, and name it as TV and save it. So both the folders are connected. As you can see, it's scanning the data on the computer, and first one shared says unshared. So when we click on it, go to add it, and under sharing there is an option, like if we select PC Mac, then it will start sharing. You can see not shared. So before doing this step, we'll go to advance, and you can see the folder type. It says send and receive. So that means the data which is on our Raspberry Pi and on the computer folder will be synced together. So if something deleted on our Pi or on our computer, that will be deleted from both the devices. So I recommend you to use send only here. So this device can send the data to Raspberry Pi and nothing will delete. So this one is done. Once we go into sharing and select the folder and click yes, save. So you can see desktop want to share folder movies. So when we add it, now You can see here folder path config movies. So it will create a path here in config folder and it will create movies. When we click on this arrow, it will give us other paths as well, but there is no path available. When we create our container, what we did, we create two folders. One is data one and other one is data two. So let me just go ahead and show you under portainer and under containers, we have sync thing running. So when we click on it and move down, we have attached two folders. Data one is for movies. So what we do is copy this data one from here and paste it here. Paste. So before moving forward, let me just go ahead and show you that under media, we have movies and these are the movies available. So let's just close it and save the information. Now the sync will start and this will move all the movies from this device to our Raspberry Pi. Now in the next step, we'll do the same with the TV. Edit, sharing, PC Mac, and then advanced, and we need send only. Save. So again, add, change the path to data 2 and save it. Once we do that, it also starts scanning the data. Now it says up to date, scanning the data. So the movie will move to that folder. You can see, let me just show you. Here are the TV series, two TV series available. And back here, what we have, okay, media and then TV series. We have only one series available. So it starts syncing in a moment. You can see on the bottom, the PC Mac syncing 27%. It's around 7.41 GB. So it will take some time. So I'm going to fast forward the video and we'll be back once it's sync complete. So we can see here that the sync is almost 71% under movies and under TV it's 96%. So let's just go ahead and check under media and TV series. So we have one, two series also available here. So the sync will complete after some time. And with the movies as well, the other movies also synced up to this movies folder. Let me just show you under the other folder, that is right here, movies. So these three movies are available on here, bypass. So the movies are moved to this folder and they are on both the locations. So location is not changed. So that's why I told you to go ahead and go for send only instead of send and receive. So guys, that's it for today. If you like my work, please hit the like button, subscribe to my channel, press the bell notification, share this video with your family and friends. Thank you for watching. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.